Goose and Tudor Promotions, Antonio Leonard Productions, and Matchroom Sport in association with Caesars Atlantic City, as sponsored by Corona and Azad Watches, present the Super 6 World Boxing Classic Final, live on Showtime on Saturday, starting at 9 p.m. Eastern. Tickets are indeed available, Boardwalk Hall, Box Office, and of course Ticketmaster as well. The prices do range from $50 to $300. And for our press, we do want to alert you that the press room will be open Thursday morning at 9 a.m., and that is at the Apollo Room at Caesars Atlantic City. Also, in regards to the weigh-in, we'll also be at Caesars Atlantic City, 5 p.m. on Friday evening. And at this time, we'd like to hear some words from Showtime. At this time, my pleasure to introduce to you the man who did so much to put all of this together. From the beginning of the tournament to right now until Saturday night, he's been a true workhorse, Vice President of Communications for Showtime Sports, Mr. Chris de Blasio.
Thank you. Thanks, Jimmy. It's been 2 years, 2 months, and the Super 6 World Boxing Classic has produced some intense drama, both inside and outside the ring. We've had 11 fights, 8 world-class fighters, each with a resume more impressive than the last. We've had 2 big knockouts, we've had 1 complete shutout, we've seen a disqualification, and virtually every kind of decision that you can have in boxing: unanimous, split, majority, and technical. We've had injury delays, back injuries, a knee injury, a training cut, the withdrawal of 3 of the original Super 6 participants. We've had promoter disputes, seemingly constant squabbling about perceived advantages and disadvantages, every minute detail of an event debated, disputed, argued, which is a testament to the importance of each tournament fight. We even had a volcano nearly sidetrack one of the fights in the Super 6. But through it all, the Super 6 World Boxing Classic has persevered, as have the 2 fighters, our finalists, who are here with us today. We've witnessed the emergence of a young U.S. Olympian rise from unranked, promising hopeful to world champion and top 10 pound-for-pound fighter. We've seen a rugged British champion fight through the most formidable list of opponents of any active fighter today. And if you don't believe that, you can have a look at Carl Froch's record starting in 2008. Showtime Sports set out with the Super 6 to pit the best fighters against the best, to eliminate any confusion about who was the man to beat in a deep super middleweight division. It was called groundbreaking, ambitious, even audacious. To date, with just 1 final tournament bout remaining, the Super 6 has delivered the most important divisional matchups at 168 pounds. It has accelerated the pace at which these fighters would face the top opposition. It's dispelled the notion that 1 loss on a fighter's resume could sidetrack his career. And it's allowed you all in the press and fans around the world to sustain conversation about these boxers, relevant conversation both inside and outside the ring when they were fighting and when they weren't, and it's as they've progressed through the gauntlet that is the Super 6. It's provided a steady diet of compelling matchups for fans, and it has led to arguably the most significant fight in the history of the division, a fight between the number 1 ranked and the number 2 ranked super middleweights in the world. So on behalf of our brand new Executive Vice President and General Manager of Showtime Sports, Steven Espinoza, our Executive Producer on our live shows, David Dinkins Jr., our Creative Director and Executive Producer for the Fight Camp 360 series, Earl Fash, and all of us at Showtime who have worked to see this tournament to its conclusion, I want to thank you all in the press for your attention throughout this incredible endeavor. Both the positive, negative, and otherwise, all of the things that you've written and all of the attention you've given to the tournament have helped to elevate the sport and the profile of the 2 finalists that are here today. I want to thank Eddie Hearn and Dan Goosen and your entire teams for the outstanding work you've done through this tournament's promotion. And finally, to our finalists, Andre Ward and Carl Froch. You've stayed committed to the Super 6, and you've survived the challenging ordeal, both physically and mentally. You both are on the brink of accomplishing one of the most significant feats in boxing history. I want to wish you both good luck. May the best man win.
Thank you very much, Chris de Blasio. At this time, we'd like to invite the teams to take their place on the stage. We invite Team Froch, promoter Eddie Hearn, and trainer Robert McCracken. Up to the stage, Team Ward, promoter Dan Goosen, and head trainer Virgil Hunter. Also from the New Jersey State Athletic Control Board, Mr. Aaron Davis and Mr. Ken Condon. Also joining us, Antonio Leonard from Antonio Leonard Productions. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we introduce the principals for this battle for greatness, the Super 6 World Boxing Classic Final. Introducing first, he is 3-1 in tournament action. Joining us from Nottingham, England, here is the two-time and current WBC Super Middleweight Champion of the World, Carl the Cobra Froch. And now, he is undefeated in tournament action. From Oakland, California, the Olympic gold medalist and undefeated WBA Super Middleweight Champion of the World, Andre S.O.G. Ward. And we ask our fighters to take their seats. We'll proceed at this time, starting with a gentleman to say a few words to properly introduce Team Ward acclaimed trainer. We have Carl Froch's promoter from Matchroom Sport. Please welcome Mr. Eddie Hearn. A gentleman to say a few words.
Thanks, Jimmy. So we're here, guys, after an amazing 2 years, over 2 years this journey's taken. Once again, we must take our hat off to Showtime. Without doubt, the most groundbreaking boxing experience of all time. I wish we could have it in every weight division. So eliminate the politics and just let the fight, the best fight the best every time. These two guys, you know, you can't take your hat off to them enough. They're the last two standing from a world-class field. And you have to give respect to both guys. You know, when you take off your vest and you take off your head guard as an amateur, you dream of nights like this Saturday. It's what boxing and what sport is all about. Two of the most prestigious belts in boxing on the line, of course, the Super 6 Cup and the Ring Magazine belt. So we wish best of luck to Andre's team and, of course, to our man, Carl Froch. You know, I think that there's not many places I'd less like to be than in the ring with Carl Froch on Saturday night. He's hungry, he's stubborn, he's motivated. He's got the backing of our team, he's got the backing of his family, he's got the backing of the whole of Britain behind him. You know, the job that Sky Sports have done with him recently, he's their number one fighter, he's Britain's number one fighter, without any question of a doubt, now even more so. And we're looking to do a job, and this is his chance really to go out and dominate boxing, not just in Britain, but in the world. This is a fight between two of the best super middleweights in the world to become the best super middleweight in the world. And it's not often in sport that you get an opportunity to have a fight like that. So, you know, we're all buzzing for that. I just want to, I know that one question is going to come to us, so I'm going to preempt that and answer that for you. There's a lot of concern, particularly in our country. There's been a couple of contentious decisions lately for British fighters fighting abroad. And I just wanted to make a note that we're very, very comfortable working with Aaron. I've had a good, great experience working with a number of fights in Atlantic City. You know, we have absolutely no problem, although we're the away fighter, we don't feel like an away fighter. You know, Carl fights anywhere, anytime, in anyone's backyard. And the American fans embrace him probably just as much as they embrace Andre Ward, because he's a real fighter who provides entertainment every time. So we believe we've got a great referee in Steve Smoja. We've got a great commission with the New Jersey Commission and Aaron. We've got three great judges, and we're very happy. I know we'll get questions later, but we're very comfortable that we'll get a fair crack of the whip. We never ask for any favours. We just want a fair crack of the whip, and we're confident that we're going to get that here. So thanks to everyone, to Showtime, of course, to Krista Balazio and all the team, and Earl and Jimmy, who have worked meticulously throughout this project for the last 2 years, and of course to Sky Sports, Barney Francis and Adam Smith for believing in us and believing in Carl, and believe us, he's ready to do the business on Saturday night. Thank you.
Thank you very much to Eddie, and at this time we'd like to present Carl's head trainer, acclaimed trainer who has done so much to bring this gentleman, this world champion, to be fighting, as Chris said, the toughest schedule of opponents that we have seen in boxing, maybe in the history. Please welcome Mr. Robert McCracken.
Thank you. Obviously, I'm very proud of Carl, what he's achieved in boxing and what he'll continue to achieve. He's got a great resume, he's fought some of the very best fighters on the planet, and he's a real winner. And obviously, with him being from Britain, it really helps. It's great what he's done, achieved, the great things he's done and got to the final. And obviously, it's another big fight with Andre Ward, who's a real good fighter. You can't get to the final in this tournament without being a real good fighter. What we've got is two great fighters fighting on a Saturday night. I'm a boxing fan. I like watching Andre Ward. I think he's a real good fighter. Good work. Him and his coach have worked together over the last few years and did a real good job. But Carl Froch is a different kind of fighter. He's a real prize fighter. And the only exception I take to any of the stuff that's been said leading up to this fight, and you know, most of it's been the right stuff because it's a fight. But I noticed Andre and Virgil touched on Mikkel Kessler, a couple of the other fighters that he fought recently, Beaker, etc. Stopped fighting halfway through the fight. When they realised they weren't going to win, they stopped fighting. They went into survival mode. I can guarantee you now, but you should already know this anyway, because Carl Froch we're talking about, he will fight the fight, and he will fight to the bitter end. And he's coming to win Saturday night, and we're confident he's going to win. But let them not be mistaken for 1 second. Things go wrong and things go right during 12 rounds for every fighter. But trust me, if he has a bad round, the next round, he'll be there, he'll be fighting, and he'll be ready. So you've got no problem Saturday night. Carl Froch will deliver on Saturday, that's for sure.
Now it's time to send it over to Team Ward. Representing Team Ward is his promoter, no stranger to center stage, no stranger to the microphone, from Goosen Tudor Promotions, Mr. Dan Goosen.
Keep the applause down, please. Not even my own team applauded, okay? You guys are in trouble. No, I think they're all just tired out waiting. First off, I do want to thank you for all waiting and being patient, and I'm glad that Carl and his team did show up. Eddie, I know you just came in from a long flight, so you know, we accomplished that part of it. Before we get going and I bring up a few people to have a few words with you, I do want to thank Showtime. I felt this tournament has been a whole different direction for boxing, one that can't be accomplished that often, because I don't believe it's an easy task to get six of the best fighters in any one division to pre-agree to fight one another in a continual tournament, win, lose, or draw. And I know that Chris earlier from Showtime mentioned some of the great words that were attached to this tournament when it was announced. And I think it's lived up to everything that it should have lived up to, despite any of the obstacles it faced. Because we're sitting here now today with the two original Super Six fighters, one from England, one from America. Wasn't the way that it was planned, I don't believe, considering that the three Europeans were the three favorites to take home this cup. America's got something to say about that. Andre Ward wasn't considered to be able to get past Kessler, much less be sitting here tonight, and his journey has just begun. Anyway, I wanted to thank Matt Blank and the new incoming VP, Steven Espinoza, but all the team with Showtime. Chris, you've done a marvelous job. Earl, Jody, all the cameramen with Fight Camp 360, and Earl with putting it all together. Jimmy, where would Showtime be without you? I want to also thank Don Marandino, who's the president of Caesars. He was scheduled to be here today. Instead, he brought his trusty right-hand man, who's been a miracle worker on transforming Atlantic City into a city that I actually look forward to going to. I know many, many years ago, it was drub and dirty. And today, you've got the Versace's there. I don't want to say this too loud. My wife may want to end up showing up 3 days early, but you got Chanel. You've got all the great stores out there. And Caesars has just done a tremendous job supporting boxing. Atlantic City hasn't seen this since the days of Donald Trump and Mike Tyson. So I want to bring up a young man from Caesars. I've known him for close to 25, 30 years now. He is the one that buys the entertainment for all of the Caesars properties, Harrah's properties, Mr. Ken Condon. Ken?
Thank you. Thank you, Dan. I'm gonna invoke the three B's of speeches: be bright, be brief, and be gone. Because all the thanks have been given. It is a holiday season, so we should be thankful for a lot of things. Thankful that Showtime and Dan and Ed were able to reschedule this bout and keep it in Atlantic City. Got it in just under the wire. I'm thankful for our great partnership, Caesars Atlantic City and the New Jersey Boxing Commission. It's been a very busy year in Atlantic City, and we're very thankful for that. And we're thankful for these two great fighters. And Jimmy went over all of the availability of ticket prices and things, so we won't repeat that, but I only have one request of Carl and Andre. I really hadn't decided what I wanted for the holidays, and what I want out of you guys is a fight of the year on December 17th in Atlantic City. So gentlemen, good luck to both of you. We look forward to hosting you in Atlantic City, and we look forward to having a great night of boxing in Atlantic City. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ken. You know, Ken touched on something, the fight of the year, and I believe that these two, it's impossible not to be right up there with some of the great fights that boxing has seen this year. And I believe that we're finally on the right track the last 24 months. And quite frankly, it could have been the Super 6 tournament that really started it, where everyone's fighting one another in today's world for the most part. And you lose, it doesn't mean it's over. Carl Froch is living proof of that with his loss to Kessler coming back and sitting here now in the finals. Ken also mentioned the New Jersey State Boxing Authority here. I think they're one of the top commissions in the world today. They've done a great job of bringing big fights back to Atlantic City, New Jersey. I want to have them say a few words. The head of the commission, Aaron Davis. Aaron? The only man to make me look this small.
That means I need to go on a diet. Well, again, I'd like to thank everybody, Showtime, both of the promoters, to feel that New Jersey is the place to have this fight. They entrust me with the decisions on having the judges, the referees, and it's a hard task because we have so many good judges and referees. The ones that we have for this weekend are undoubtedly some of the best in the world. And probably at the end of the night, you won't be worried about what the judges say or what the referee says. We're going to highlight who we need to highlight, and these are these two fighters right here. And I'm just wonderful. I'm just thankful to be a part of it. Again, Atlantic City, they say in Vegas that boxing's dead. These last couple months, I don't believe it's dead. How about you guys? It's not dead. So thank you, and I'll see you guys Saturday night.
Thank you very much, Aaron. Well, the team that you see here with Andre Ward, one of the things that makes me very proud, it's the same team that's been here since the day Andre turned pro after winning the gold medal. And it's hard to say that too often in our sport, or quite frankly, any sport. So it's a testament to the leader, Andre Ward, who laces up those gloves, goes into that ring, but he's kept that loyal foundation with the same team intact, and it's paid its dividends. Part of the team and a man that saw this talent long before Andre won the gold medal, long before he became world champion, was James Prince. He's got an eye for talent. He's shown it in music, and he has shown it in the boxing business. Manager of Andre Ward, James Prince. James?
I'd like to thank God for this opportunity. Showtime, Goosen, Tudor, my friend Tony, y'all done a spectacular job with bringing everything along. Team Froch, we thank you all for showing up. This has been a beautiful journey that we've been on as a team, and you know, we've accomplished and defeated every obstacle set before us. To God be the glory. Come Saturday night, it won't be no different. You know, we believe no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And on Saturday night, you will see Andre Ward at his best. And last but not least, we definitely represent the United States of America, as we done in the 2004 Olympics. We plan on making every United States citizen proud of us come Saturday night. Thank you.
Thank you, James. My co-promoter, gentleman that a lot of you don't know, as the years go on, you're getting to know him. And believe me, he's young enough to be out here for many more years to come. He does a tremendous job of keeping things together for Goose and Tudor. Want to bring him up? Antonio Leonard. Come on, let's hear an applause for Antonio. Otherwise, he'll stay up on the microphone for 15 minutes. Antonio.
I'm going to make it real quick, because I'm going to say the same story that I've been saying ever since I met this gentleman in 2002. He gave me, James, Elwood Jackson, Dan Goosen, Virgil Hunter, a promise that he was going to win a gold medal in 2004. He did that, and he told us he'll become world champion, and he done that. And I would definitely say that I think two of the best fighters, super middleweights in the world, are on this stage tonight, and I think it's going to be a tremendous fight. And one thing I can say about Mr. Carl Froch, he talks the talk, and we're going to see if he can walk the walk. But definitely on this Saturday, there's no doubt in my mind that Andre Ward will be the WBA, the WBC, and the super middleweight champion of the world, because Andre Ward, he is Showtime.
Don't be taking Jimmy Lennon's lines, okay? Those are just to him. Now, Antonio, there's a lot of people that talk the talk. We're not going to see Carl Froch, all due respect to you, Carl, walk the walk, because you've got the unfortunate challenge of having Andre Ward on the other side of the ring. He doesn't do a lot of talking, but he does a lot of walking. The man that really has taught him what he knows, and I've been saying it for the last 2 years during this tournament, the best is yet to come with Andre Ward. When he started this tournament, he was 25-year-old, just going into a fight with the world champion Kessler. Since that time, we've seen him grow each and every fight. Saturday night, we're going to see him at another level. The major reason for that is the gentleman on my right, who I think is one of the best trainers in the world today. I know that is thrown around a lot, but this man knows how to teach, knows how to put up a game plan, and knows how to mentally prepare a fighter. I'm proud to be associated with him. He's done a tremendous job. Godfather of Andre Ward, he's been with him since he's been 9 years old. Virgil Hunter, Virgil.
Thanks, Dan. I'd like to thank everybody for coming out once again for this fabulous event that's going to involve these two great gladiators. And we're definitely proud to be a part of it. I'm going to be very brief, and I feel great that Coach has said that Carl will fight, and I always will believe, I always believe that. And when I made that statement, it wasn't towards Carl at all. It was the other fighters that at some point along the line, they quit engaging. But I never doubted in my mind that Carl Froch would be that type of opponent. So as to go along with, to alternate that with promoter Eddie, we got our bags packed for the trip that Carl's gonna take us on. We got our bags packed, he's got his camera, he's got his binoculars, he's got all his sightseeing things in his suitcase, and he's prepared to go along on that ride and going places that he's never been before. And I think as he goes along on the ride that he'll recognize very quick that the terrain is very familiar to him. Andre will know that he's been there before. So I look for a great fight. We're prepared for this fight and anything that arises in the fight. Thank you.
Thank you, Verge. Also, for everyone that's looking at the press conference online right now, go to our Twitter account at GoosenTutor and put in the hash word SOG. SOG. We're giving away two free tickets to the lucky winner. So go to our Twitter account at GoosenTutor. Is that right, Danny? Did I do that right? All this confounded newfound electronics. Well, you know, who said it? Was it you, Chris, that said there were problems with promoters? Was it you? I was never involved in any of those problems you're saying, I hope. But what hasn't been a problem, and really class acts, are the team of Mr. Barry Hearn and his son, Eddie. They've been true professionals, and I have to say words like this, and I don't really mean it, okay? Here I mean it. They're class people. I've known Eddie's dad for many, many years, and Eddie is certainly following in his dad's footsteps. I know that Carl has certainly felt a lot more comfortable with the promoter team of Matchroom Sports behind him, and that's due to Eddie's learning process he learned from his dad. Anyway, I want to introduce him now and then let him introduce his champion, Mr. Eddie Hearn. Eddie.
Thanks, Dan. That was lovely. Brought a tear to the eye, actually. I'd like to introduce a gentleman who you've actually seen walk the walk every time he steps into the ring. So underestimate him at your peril. He's a two-time WBC champion, the Cobra, Carl Froch.
Thank you, Eddie. I'm going to keep it brief, very brief, actually. I think the time for talking is most definitely over. I'm going to do my talking in the ring on the 17th of December. It's a cliche, but trust me. I've had a great response from the British fans and the American fans as it goes. I've got hundreds, close to thousands actually, of people flying over from Nottingham, London, Birmingham, Manchester, Sheffield, where I've trained. They're just, they've taken me by surprise actually, because it's so close to Christmas. Economically, it's difficult at the minute for people. And, you know, they've dug deep twice as well, some of them, because of the cancellation of the original date on the 29th of October. So, you know, it's hit people. So I want to say a big thank you to all my fans, big shout out to them. And I guarantee you, you will not be disappointed with what you see on Saturday night. I am in the best shape of my life. It's as simple as that. I've been on the weight now for a couple of weeks. I'm feeling sharp, strong, confident. You know, physically and mentally, I couldn't be in better shape. There's a smile on my face because I know I'm ready. I know Saturday night is going to be my night. And a lot of people know, people that are close to me know when I'm confident and when I'm in shape, when things have gone good and things have gone very good. Big thank you to Eddie Hearn and Matchroom Sports. Big thank you, first and foremost, actually, even though I mentioned him second, Robert McCracken. You know, he's my trainer, my mentor. He just means everything to me in terms of boxing and bringing out the best in me, and, you know, the whole journey that we've had together from start to finish. Without Robert McCracken, you know, this wouldn't be happening. Well, I certainly wouldn't be sat here anyway, that's for sure. So big, big thanks to Robert. He's a fantastic man. I can't sing his praises enough. You know, we've come all this way and we're both in the final, and we're here to win this tournament and win these belts. I'm defending my WBC title. I'm aiming to put the WBA and the Super 6 trophy on my cabinet, along with all my other trophies. Big thanks to Showtime. They put the whole Super 6 together, and Sky Sports, in stunning high definition, is also showing the fight. And, you know, the team are all fantastic. And the Fight Camp 360 team as well, you know, the guys that put the 360 together, that not a lot of people in Britain have seen, but they're seeing it this week. They're an absolute, real bunch of gentlemen. And they work very hard around the clock. They fly to England, they're coming to my house. So hopefully I've treated them well, and they've been looked after by Team Cobra, but they're a real sound bunch of men, and I just want to say thank you to all them guys on the Fight Camp 360 crew. It's been a wonderful journey, one in which I've enjoyed. I'm looking forward to capping it on Saturday night. So we'll pass it to the floor, because I'm sure you've got plenty of questions to ask one-to-one, so we'll cut to the chase, and thanks for coming. Cheers.
Thank you, Carl. Andre Ward, I truly know that when the American public catches hold of it, and it's constantly moving in that direction, every fight's a different level, that they see the public face of him, of his faith, of his clean life, his family life, loyalty, and then everything that I just said thrown inside the ring of a viciousness that I believe is second to none. It's been an honor to see him win the gold medal for America, and Saturday night, it'll be an honor to see him raise that cup above his head. He's got his work cut out for him. We all have a lot of respect for Carl Froch, but the best is yet to come from Andre Ward. Please let me introduce your WBA Super Middleweight World Champion, Andre SOG Ward.
Thank you, everybody. I want to thank the assembled media, the fans that are here.
Every time you use that,
you know, like it's been said, it's been a lot of talk, too much talk in my opinion, about the back and forth. This is my favorite time, when it's time to get down and show down. The fight is a few days away. I love to speak the loudest the night of the fight. I love big moments like this. I love big fights like this. Carl Froch is the self-proclaimed best fighter in England. I love it. I want to fight the best, and I want to beat the best. Every single fight, I'm in the best shape of my life. Every fight, I push myself to the limit, and this fight has been no different. This is the finals of the Super 6, but every fight we take serious mentally and physically, and we put in the work, and we're extremely well prepared, and we're in a great place mentally and physically as well. You know, a lot of people keep talking to me about being the favorite. We're not the favorite. We're not the favorite. I still have that chip on my shoulder, and that's how I prepare, and that's how I prepare from day one, because for some reason there seems to be, from Froch's camp and even from some of the media, some questions about toughness, about physicality, and things like that. And it's almost like, you know, there's a sense that I'm hoping to come in and squeak by a victory. You don't squeak victories like this out. You take them. And that's what I'm prepared to do. He's made some references to my faith, disrespectfully. He said some things, physical, you know, you don't have a punch, you don't have, I love it, man. I'm looking forward to this fight. This fight should be dubbed No Excuses. Carl Froch beats me, there won't be no excuses. I beat Carl Froch, there should be no excuses. No judges, no referees, no nothing. And may the best man win come Saturday night.
Jimmy, I'm going to throw it back to you. I imagine we're going to do some Q&As.
Yeah, you guessed it right. At this time, we do have a couple of microphones on the floor here. I want to remind you, we have a large number of viewers watching online, so this is a good chance to ask your questions. We'll have limited times for one-on-ones. The fighters have a busy schedule. As we have two microphones right here.
Here you go, sir. Yeah, hi, Jack Hirsch, Boxing News for Carl. Andre Ward was accused by Mikhail Kessler of using his head a lot. Is that a concern of yours?
Not really. I've got a head as well, you know, and we've got a referee in there to sort the job out. You know, it's been mentioned a few times. Maybe a bigger deal if it's been made because I've brought it up. It's obviously a concern in the sense that you don't want to be getting headbutted in the face or in the eyes, because if you get caught and if you get blood in the eye, it can be a very big hindrance. And that happened quite often in the Mikhail Kessler fight, and Ward was allowed to get away with that. So that's what's raised the concern. But personally, it's not something that I go to bed thinking about at night, and it's not a major concern, because, like I say, the referee and the officials are totally aware of their job, what they need to do. And this is such a fight of such magnitude, you know, it's all going to be fair and above board, I'm sure. And I'm looking forward to a great, clean fight.
Thank you. Let me make a comment on that. Let me kind of piggyback off of this. I told some of the reporters earlier about this. See, they want to overcompensate and put it out there to the referee, look out for his head. I don't lead with my head. I'm a rugged fighter. When I fight inside, things happen. I don't have a malicious bone in my body. That's one fight that people try to tag me with being a dirty fighter. But go back and do your homework and look at the Andre Durrell fight. Look at the rabbit punches. Look at the way he threw Durrell down. Look at that fight and listen to the commentary. Listen to the commentary where they basically said, well, Carl Froch's probably gonna have to get a point taken to make him stop doing what he's doing. So if we're going to tag me off of one fight, let's be fair and do the same with him. Just like he has concerns, we got concerns too. This man is online talking about how he's going to spear me with his elbow if I come in with my head. If that's not dirty, I don't know what is. I can put my head on anybody's chest in a boxing match. That's part of boxing. But if we're going to tag me with one fight and define my career by one instance that happened, that may not be the last time that I'm involved in headbutts. It happens. This is the physical battle. This is the fight. Do the same thing with him.
If I can just say that with the Andre Durrell fight, all I was doing there was trying to make the fight. You know, I was in against a guy who was very negative, and, you know, he was on his back foot, and he was almost running scared. So whatever I did with Durrell was in an attempt to make the fight happen, and I think I did a good job of that and gave the crowd and the television broadcasters some great entertainment without infringing any rules. And, you know, the referee didn't deduct any points off me, deducted points off Durrell for holding. So, you know, that sums it up, and I told you all you need to know.
Question.
This is for Carl. Could you just tell us how you've grown as a fighter in and out of the ring during this whole tournament process?
This tournament's given me the opportunity to fight some of the very best fighters in the world, and you learn every single time you fight. You learn about your offense, you know, what your best punches are, your defense, how to avoid shots. And, you know, I've evolved over the last 2 years. I feel physically fitter, mentally I've grown, If I could grow any more mentally, I'm so confident and, you know, mentally strong and switched on. You'd think that'd be hard, but you can always add to what you've already got. I've definitely got an extra string to my bow with this tournament and with the level of fighters I've had. I mean, I didn't get the decision against Mikel Kessler, but I grew as a fighter, and that brought me on and made me even more confident because of the outcome of that fight and then what I did to get that corrected. So, you know, I could talk for an hour about how much I've learned and what I've learned technically and mentally and physically, how I've grown into my physical peak performance, which I'm at the minute. I really do feel like I'm in my peak at 34 years old. I just feel so fit and strong. I can see why some of the triathletes peak mid to late 30s and even 40s, you know, aerobically, because I diarise everything I do, and I'm hitting and breaking targets at the minute, which is fantastic for my confidence. So it's coming on and building all the time. I think that answers your question, really.
Mark Chandler, BBC. Carl, will you be targeting Andre's cut, or is that something of a distraction?
I'll be trying to hit Andre Ward in the face very hard, very often. Will I be targeting the right eye or the left eye, whichever cut is, if I'm totally honest? No, it's going to be too difficult to target a square inch on somebody's cranium. But, you know, if it's there for the taking, then I'm going to look a gift horse in the mouth. I'm not banking on his cut opening up, I'm really not. I'd rather his cut not open up, because I don't want that to be a reason for why I win the contest. I want it to be a fair fight and a fight between two warriors who deserve to be in there. So to answer your question, no, I won't be targeting his cut, not at all. I think it'll be fully healed, which I hope it is, and he's fully fit and ready to go, really do.
Andre begs a question, are you fully healed from that cut?
Absolutely. If we weren't fully healed, we wouldn't be here. I think it'd be a disservice to my opponent, a disservice to this tournament, to not come in 100%. You know, I doubt that Carl would want me in a fight with him not 100%. I don't think that'd be right. So that's the long answer, but absolutely. We've been through a full training camp, and it's not even a topic that has come up in camp. So absolutely.
This is for Carl. Did the postponement have any negative impact on your training?
No, the postponement, I mean, it's easy for me to say it did me a favour, but it did. I don't know if I mentioned before to the American press, but my coach, Rob McCracken, also has a huge responsibility in Britain for the Great Britain boxing team for the Olympic Games coming up in 2012. You know, he's a master in his art, and that's why he's got that job there. And he was actually away on a two-week world championship tournament in Azerbaijan right before the week I was going to fly out to New York for the day on the 29th of October. So, you know, I was without one. We'd worked around it. I was having a week off, and then I was back in the gym for a week with Rob before we flew out there. But the postponement actually did me a favour. The only thing I regret about the postponement is the fact that a lot of fans had booked flights, and, you know, they got hit financially. But other than that, I'm... if it's possible, I'm in better shape for December 17th than what I would have been for October 17th. So it's not been an issue, and it's of no fault of Andre Ward, that, you know, he sustained a cut. He felt he had to pull out of the fight. It was a bad cut. He did the right thing, and if that's what he needed to do, then he did the right thing for himself. So there's no problem with that. There's no needle. And like I say, to answer your question, December 17th has done me a little bit of a favour. So I'm happy about the postponement.
Hi, this is Mike Natalino from Mike's Night at the Fights. This question directed towards Andre Ward. Andre, I see that you're, I don't want to say out of character, but a little bit more agitated than I've seen you in prior to...
Just call it firm.
Firm.
Just be firm.
Do you feel that this is going to take you out of character in the ring of fighting a disciplined fight at all?
Absolutely not. I'm the way that I always am. I'm always like this. It's 2-3 days away from a big fight. But again, just like my fighting style, people will throw things out there. He's a nice guy, which I am. He's a family man, which I am. And they'll get caught up in some of the press that they read instead of really looking at me for who I am. I'm a warrior. But people only give you the warrior tag if you if you get, you know, cut every other fight, if you're, you know, fight of the year candidate every other fight, that's when you get, I'm a warrior, man, and I'm coming to win something, and I'm coming to take something. So, and I've been away from my family for 2 months, so this is the purpose of training camp, to get you in this type of mode. So I'm far from being out of character.
Carl, good to see you again. Question for you. You're always outspoken. You always have a lot to say. Makes it colorful. My question, are you trying to lure Andre into a fight with these tactics that you're using?
No, not at all. I'm just, like you say, I'm outspoken, but I speak the truth. I tell it how it is. I'm a straight shooter. So if anybody's got any questions for me to answer, they know they're going to get an honest answer from Carl Froch. So if people feel that I'm being a little brash and a bit harsh, or I'm trying to upset anybody, then that's for them to draw judgment. I'm just answering the questions honestly and precisely to the best of the information I'm given and what I see. You know, I think Andre Ward at the minute is having a fight with himself. It's got nothing to do with me.
Wish you both the best of luck on Saturday night.
Appreciate that.
Thank you. Question for Andre first, and then Carl. Does the winner of this fight need to fight Lucien Boutte to be universally regarded as the best?
Most definitely not. I need to cut you up there, and I'm sorry to be ignorant to stop you in your tracks, but Lucien Boutte isn't in the mix. I know he's IBF champion, but the two names on his record are Brian McGee and Glencoff Johnson. That's it. He lost to a guy. He got knocked out by a guy called Liberon Andrade in round 12 of his fight. He actually got KO'd, and the referee picked him off the floor, washed his gum shield 40 seconds later, and the bell was rung early, and he won that fight on points, but in my opinion, he was knocked out. So, you know, Lucien Boutte needs to fight a couple of top-level fighters before he can call himself the best of the best, or in the top three in the world, or top two in the world, like myself and Andre Wardar. But obviously, he's IBF champion, and that would make, you know, the winner of this tournament and the winner of these two glorious belts a natural progression to go to unify the division. So, you know, he may get his chance to get an absolute whooping, because that's what would happen, and you'll see that when it happens.
Yeah, I agree. You know, the winner of this fight, Lucien Boutte has to fight the winner to become the best, and that's just the bottom line. With the Ring Magazine belt and all the other belts on the line, no disrespect to Lucien Boutte, but he's fought, you know, B-minus, C-level competition, and he's done what he was supposed to do. He got him out of there, but he's been almost preserving himself, just trying to wait for the winner of this tournament, while we've been putting in a lot of hard work. So, absolutely not. You know, we have nothing else to prove in terms of who's the best after this fight. He has to come to us. We don't have to go to him.
I have a question for Carl. This is Jerry Blickman, Seconds Out. You like to say that you're going to, when you said this for other fighters, you're going to win by any means possible. That can mean a lot of different things to a lot of people. What does that mean to you? You always say it.
Whatever I need to do to win on the night, I will do. That's what that means.
I know, but it's more specifically.
I don't know how I can be any more specific without talking tactics and different variations of, you know, whatever action comes at me, I will have to react accordingly. So I could talk to you about if Andre Ward decides to box and move, what I'll do. If he decides to come forward and be aggressive, what I'll do. If he decides to do both, what I'll do. I'll do whatever I need to do to win the fight.
Does it mean responding kind to fouls?
You can draw from my comments exactly what you want, to write what you want, to print what you want. But I'm just saying I will do anything. I'll win by any means necessary. It starts and ends there, period.
Thank you.
Chris, we have a question in the back.
What question for Andre Ward. Andre, Michael Marley, examiner.com. You're very open about your ardent religious beliefs, in a way you're like Tim Tebow in that respect. Your nickname, SOG, Son of God. You said that Mr. Froch was disrespectful to you regarding your religious beliefs. Could you flesh that out, explain that? And do you feel that he's mocked your enthusiastic religious beliefs?
Absolutely. I think it was some reference made to my nickname. if I'm not mistaken, something was said about me being ignorant for taking on that nickname. So yeah, absolutely, I take offense to that. My faith is not a crutch, it's my foundation, it's everything to me. And so when you hear something like that, yeah, absolutely, I take offense to that.
I think there's two subjects you should leave alone, and one of them is religion, so not really, no.
This is Uncle Chuck Nitty, Jim of Hard Knocks. I'd just like to ask Mr. Ward, you've been known to make tough warriors look sort of like Girl Scouts up against the ropes and very comfortable. Do you have plans of doing that to Mr. Froch as well?
This is the bottom line. I don't get caught up in all the hoopla. I expect this to be, and I prepare for this to be, physically and mentally, the toughest fight of my career, period. And I expect it to be the toughest fight of his career. And anything less would be as a bonus. So neither his prior fights, neither of my prior fights mean anything. It's all about Saturday night. That's what it boils down to.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Chris, we've had a request that that be the final question. Unless you object, we're going to move along to our photo opportunities. We're going to have Chris de Blasio direct us following the photo opportunities on the stage, one-on-ones on the stage. And then the fighters will be off to their business. Once again, we thank you very much for being here. Those viewing us online, we thank you so much. Once again, it's Saturday night, Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City, New Jersey. The Super 6 World Boxing Classic Tournament Final. Once again, Saturday, December 17th, live on Showtime at 9 p.m. Eastern Time. And also, we have tickets available at the Boardwalk Hall box office and Ticketmaster.com.